The wealth of the area is not monetary, but a rich legacy of spiritual values such as faith, hope, love, courage, perseverance, labor, sacrifice, humility, and pride.
Newburg is a representation of strong people coming over a stony road of humiliation and scorn, out of slavery, without education. But they worked together and built homes, a community, a church, and even the first school in the area.
When Charles Goodwin spoke of his neighborhood, he was often quoted saying how the four founders of Newburg wanted their four heart desires. Nehemiah, can you please tell me what those were?
Most certainly. School, church, home, but most importantly, freedom from slavery.
Hey, my name is Xavier, and today we're going to show you the history of Newburg.
Newburg's history is a history of firsts. There is a rich history on how the area of Newburg was established. So let me tell you how it all began. In the late 1820s, four German families settled into the area between Popular Level Road and Old Shepherdsville Road, you know, near the McDonald's. By 1839, these four families had created several businesses and even established a post office. As a new town, the Germans' family called it Newburg, spelled N-E-U-B-U-R-G-H. Newburg in that spelling means new town in German. In 1870, the census report documented the German settlement as Newburg. Within 2 miles from where the German family settled Newburg was an area known as the Wet Woods because of the swampiness of the land. The land may have been swampy, but it was also rich in nutrients. Wet Woods was 110 acres of land owned by John Hunley, a white man who was also owned many slaves. Eliza Curtis Hunley was one of his slaves, and because of how Eliza cared for him as he battled the smallpox pandemic, upon his death in 1830, he willed Eliza her freedom and his land. In Hunley's will, Eliza was given $200,000, a farmhouse, and ownership over the 20 enslaved people who worked the land. Many of the 20 enslaved people were related to Eliza, so she was not seen as their new owner, but more as Aunt Eliza. Eliza's inherited farmhouse used to sit on what is now Bathford Manor Mall. 10 years later, in 1840, Eliza Curtis Hunley married Henry Tivis, a free black man. Together, they farmed the land and helped others raise the children in the area. Eliza and Henry never had children of their own, but were loved and respected by many. When families were separated at the Louisville slave market, Eliza was known to take in the babies and small children and raise them on the land she and her husband owned. She was called Aunt Eliza throughout the community and was known for her strong religious faith, her ability to create natural medicines from herbs and berries, and being able to acquire land where her relatives and free blacks could feel safe and work and build homes.
In 1880, Peters Laws, a former slave, purchased 1 acre of land from the aging Aunt Eliza. Peters Laws built what was known as the first brick home at the corner of Old Shepherdsville Road and Newburg Road, near Circle K. Peter Laws was a brick mason, so constructing a home with some brick instead of logs and wood drew the attention of the German settlers. Jokingly, one German settler referred to Peter's home as Petersburg. Berg in German means town. Therefore, Petersburg was named after Peter's Laws. Petersburg is the oldest African-American settlement in Jefferson County.
Welcome to Forest Home Cemetery, where Eliza Tivis was laid to rest. This historic sign marks the site of the sacred burial area. This is the great tombstone of Eliza Tivis.
Thank you.
We're here at Newburg Park, where the old school building was.
By 1929, a new school building was being constructed behind Forest Baptist. Mr. Garvin, the first principal of the original school, was also a strong disciplinarian. Former students remember the importance of being at their desks by the time Mr. Garvin rang the school bell, this being the infamous school bell. Mr. Garvin, along with his growing staff and students, created a school song. The Newburg School song was performed for many years, but the musical arrangement was never documented. The song's lyrics remain a part of the school's history, though. So let's listen to Miss Jeffries sing the song.
Our school is the best school we know throughout the land. And it was built to demands. Fine arts, tech and math and science and history. To learn all of this to us is a mystery. Newburg, oh Newburg, you are our joy and pride. We look upon our teachers as our best guide. Newburg, oh Newburg, oh how we love you so. Proud of our school, self-control is our rule. May we always remember the days spent at Newburg School.
Another historic item from the first school in Newburg Petersburg community is this well pump right here. The first Newburg school did not have running water, so teachers and students had to pump water from this well. Frank Weaver attended this school and went on to become the elite Tuskegee Airman. This well is located right by the courtyard.
Did you know that 1969, sixth graders at Newburg Elementary School named 14th Street and the Newburg Petersburg community after famous African Americans and community leaders? These streets' names can be seen throughout the community to this day.
Welcome to Forest Baptist Church, the first church built in the Newburg Petersburg area, and my father is the current pastor.
I'm here with the lead pastor, Nathaniel Bishop, and I have a few questions for you.
Sure.
First off, how long have you been at the church?
All right. Well, I've been at this church since June of 2010. We came down from Michigan, and that allowed us to attend the Southern Seminary. But then while I was attending the seminary, we had the opportunity to serve as the youth and family pastor at this church. And once that time was over in 2014, we stayed because this church is such a wonderful church and wonderful people.
How would you say, like, this church has affected your life in a Black history standpoint?
Oh, absolutely. With this, the history of this church being the first church in this community, but then also just our name, Forest Baptist Church, that our name comes from how the former enslaved people would worship in the forest on stumps. And having that connection to the history of this area just gives me a deep appreciation for the stewardship we have. It's like a lot of responsibility, but it's also a pride in the heritage that this church has.
Thank you.
In some of these names, some of these families are still members of this church even to today. So that's some incredible history. But then also, this church has burned down twice. One time we know it was for electrical reasons, but in the time since this church was established in 1867, it's went through a couple different designs. So you see in these pictures, it started in the home of Eliza Tivis and then moved to this log cabin. So this is just like illustration of what that log cabin looked like. But then the first built church was in 1894. And then from there in 1956, and this church was actually like facing that side. But then that church burned down in an electrical fire, and then that new church was built in 1977.
Hello, everyone. I hope you are enjoying your celebration during Black History Month. But remember, Black history is American history and should be celebrated at all times. This poem I've written for you today is called When I. When I speak, it is for those who cannot talk, for those who gave their lives so that I was able to survive, so that I could sit in a seat that I chose on a bus, that separate was not equal. When I write, it is to tell the truth like my ancestors, who would not be silenced. They would not keep quiet, and they protested in the streets. Some feared for their lives, even when they suffered defeat. When I stand, it is for justice, for those who have been silenced by hate, ignorance, or fear. When I speak, it is for you. When I speak, it is for my people who think that they don't matter or they don't belong. It is to tell them and you that Black is beautiful, baby, no matter where they come from. When I write, it is to glide across your mind with my pen and my rhymes. I want you to remember Nikki Giovanni, James Baldwin, Gil Scott-Heron, Maya Angelou, and Alice Walker. And the list goes on and on. When I stand, it is for the students at Newburg to know that they are amazing, phenomenal, brilliant, determined, brave, and resilient. I don't think you heard me. It's for the students at Newburg who know that they are amazing, phenomenal, brilliant, determined, brave, and resilient. When I speak, I'm talking to you. Never stop dreaming. Never believe that the color of your skin or your background will stop you. You are more powerful than you can imagine. There is greatness inside, and there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that you can't do. Have a great day, Newburg Tigers.